Hello students of class 7, welcome back to our English class. Today, as a start of a class, I'm going to welcome a special guest to talk to you all. I know you will be wondering who the guest is. So, let's see who the guest is.
Hello friends, I am Tigy. I am a tiger. I am the largest among the wild cats. And I have two colors on my body. It's black and gold. I am said to be the strongest animal because I do hunting. And my one punch can kill a human, and all animals are scared of me. But I too love swimming, and I like playing with my friends. And I like making humans my friends too. But most often, because I'm hungry when I hunt, humans don't like me. To know more about me, now let's see a poem.
So, the name of the poem is Scratching the Tiger's Back. Scratching the Tiger's Back. So now, let me read out the poem to you first. I want all of you to listen carefully. Let me start. Regrettably, the tiger is known for fierce attack. But there are days when the tiger says, "Come here and scratch my back." His moods vary with meals. At times, the tiger is not charged with electricity. His blood isn't that hot. He feels so lazy that he lazes, stays put, doesn't go places. His stripes don't blaze, his skin doesn't glow. He feels so lazy that time and the afternoon and the winter sun turned slow. That autumn evening, when for a moment brief, light through the leaves is itself black and gold, black shadow and gold leaf. That evening, as the sun sinks, you will not think of him with fear, and even if you do, the tiger will be on the far bank, not here. That night, you will not dream of tiger as a print of black daggers and gold daggers. And even if he does enter your dreams, he will do so softly. He will not charge, he will not barge into your sleep. All he will tell you is, "I am well because I lunched well. I'm too made by God. I am a symbol. I am like you. Both good and evil dwell in me too. For good gold and evil black. Tonight, I'll say nothing. You can scratch my back." So I hope all of you listen to the poem. So now look at it in detail, stanza by stanza. So the first stanza, I want you all to read with me. Regrettably, the tiger is known for fierce attack. But there are days when the tiger says, "Come here and scratch my back." His moods vary with meals. At times, the tiger is not charged with electricity. His blood isn't that hot. He feels so lazy that he lazes, stays put, doesn't go places. His stripes don't blaze, his skin doesn't glow. He feels so lazy that time and the afternoon and the winter sun turn slow. So in this stanza, we are looking at the tiger. Here it says that most often, unfortunately, we look at a tiger as if it is very ferocious animal. But it says that you can scratch its back because it sometimes feels itchy too. And the tiger here says that it all depends upon the meal that he takes. Sometimes when he eats too much, he is full of energy and his blood isn't too hot, that he lazes a lot, and at that time his stripes on his body, they don't blaze and his skin doesn't glow. He's all lazy and doesn't even wake up from his place. So first, let's see the meaning of regrettably. It's unfortunately, and charged with electricity is full of energy. So the energy of the tiger depends upon the meal he takes. So in this stanza, we see that the tiger's mood varies with the meals he eat, and when they are not full of energy, they become lazy, or when they are even full of energy, they become lazy. Their stripes don't blaze and their skin doesn't glow. So it all depends upon the food they eat. So now let's go on to the second stanza. The autumn evening, when for a moment brief, light through the leaves is itself black and gold, black shadow and gold leaf. That evening, as the sun sinks, you will not think of him with fear. And even if you do, the tiger will be on the far bank, not here. So here we see that the tiger, when he is full, he is not gonna come. As the sun sinks in the evening, he is going to be in the far bank and not here. So for a moment brief means for a short period. A bank means land above the edge of a river. So here we see about the autumn evening during sunset, where the leaves, when the sunshine falls on them, looks gold and the shadow looks black. Here they resemble the tiger. So the author here says that you need not be scared of tigers now. Looking at the gold and the black shadows and the leaves, we might think like the tiger is coming, but here the line says that we need not be scared of the tiger because he's going to be resting in the far bank. So let's move on to the third stanza. And that night you will not dream of tigers as a print of black daggers and gold daggers. And even if he does enter your dreams, he will do so softly. He will not charge, he will not barge into your sleep. All he will tell you is, I am well because I lunched well. I am too made by God. I am a symbol, I am like you. Both good and evil dwell in me too. For good, gold, for evil, black. Tonight I'll say nothing. You can scratch my back. So here we are introduced to the voice of the tiger. Yes, the meaning of dagger is sharp weapon, and barge is moved forcefully or roughly. So here the author says that because the tiger is in the far bank, he isn't going to come and disturb us, but he might come in a dream. But the author assures us that he is not going to be as a dagger, a weapon on us, but even if he comes in our dreams, he's going to come softly. He's not going to come and barge at us like the picture you see, but he's going to come softly into our dreams, and he will tell us that he is well because he lunched well. And he also tells that he is also a creation of God, just like us humans. And he tells that he is also a symbol of God's creation. The gold in him symbolizes good, and the black is a symbol of evil. Just like how we have both good and evil in us, the tiger says that he also has both good and evil. And finally, he ends by saying, "You can scratch my back." Here in this line, in this last line specifically, he says that we can be friendly with him. We need not be scared or hate him, because he is no more going to be fierce on us. He's going to be gentle and soft because he's fully fed. So he also needs someone to scratch his back when it's itchy. So he tells us that we can be friendly to him too. Now you must be wondering, who is the poet? Am I right? So the poet is Kiki and Daruwala. Kiki and Daruwala, that is Kiki Nesarwanji Daruwala. He was born in Lahore in 1937, and he is an Indian poet and short story writer in English. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1984. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award for his poetry collections. So, you know what is interesting about him? He is also a former Indian police service officer. So he was also serving as a police. In his poems and short story, he is well known for his talent and the literary stamina that he has, and his intellectual strength and the social awareness. Just like the poem Tiger, the poet Kiki N. Daruwala has written many poems and short story based on social awareness. You may be wondering now, what is the social awareness in this poem? Here, he talks about the awareness for tigers. Yes, students. Nowadays, tigers are killed, and people think they're too dangerous and they hunt them down. The result of this is the tigers are the endangered endangered species nowadays. And it is said that there are just 3,200 tigers left in the world now. The tiger skin and the skin parts are highly in demand. They use it for making carpets, perfume, jewelry, meat and liquid content. So it is important for us, each and every individual, to put an end to hunting. And you know what? Hunting tigers are illegal. We are not supposed to hunt them. So, students, if you come to know anything that contains tiger's parts, please say a no to it. Tigers are also friendly animals. They do not harm us unnecessarily, so we must also not hunt them. Like you see in this picture, the skin of the tiger is used as a luxury decor and the meat is also consumed. The tiger's claws and teeth are used for making jewelry and decorative items, while the bone is said to be a good tonic to cure pain. They are consumed as wine and are also helpful as medical glue or paste. So, more than hunting down tigers for these things, people hunt them because they are so much scared of them. But tigers are so friendly. Just like how you see in these pictures, tigers are friendly with humans. When they are shown too much care, they are also loving towards us. So instead of hunting them down, we must take care of them and we must be friendly with them. So this is the awareness that the poet gives through the poem, where he is bringing us the voice of the tiger. So the literary devices found in the poem are: first, alliteration. Sun sings. S. Lazy lazes. L. So alliteration is nothing but the occurrence of same letter words. Second, imagery. Imagery is use of vivid and descriptive language. When they bring in clear images in mind, it is called imagery. So here they say that the stripes don't blaze and the skin doesn't glow. It gives a picture of how the skin of a tiger may glow. Third is personification, where the animal, the tiger here, is given human qualities or characteristics. Like, we humans have moods, but in this poem, tiger is given mood, and the voice of the tiger, that is, we are shown like a tiger is talking, that is personification. Next is metaphor. Metaphor is describing something by making a comparison. Here we don't use words like or as or than. In the poem, in the lines, you can see light through the leaves is itself black and gold. Here, it is indirectly compared to the tiger itself, where the tiger also has the color black and gold on him. So the next is the simile. Simile is comparing one thing with another using words like, as, or than. In the poem, you can see in the line, as a print of black dagger and gold dagger. So, a tiger is compared to a dagger. And secondly, you can see in the line, I am a symbol, I am like you. So, the tiger is compared to human. That is simile. Lastly, we have paradox, which is a self-contradictory statement. That is, the tiger says it has both good and evil. So, it is a self-contradictory statement. I hope you understood the literary devices found in the poem. So, quickly after watching the video, please go and fill in the forms that are put in the Google Classroom. And as a home assignment, I want you to write a summary on what measures you would take to protect tigers. And also, I want you to find the rhyming words in the poem. So that's all for today's class, students. Thank you. See you in our next class.